Hi everybody and welcome back to Relax My Dog. Now today's video is a little bit of a funny one because we're going to be talking about reasons not to get a dog. Not reasons why you should get a dog, but reasons why you shouldn't. Which, obviously I have a dog, so I obviously think that dogs are amazing, but we're going to be talking about if you are on the fence on whether to get a dog or whether to not get a dog at all, we're going to be talking about why you may not want to get one. And before we do get started, definitely do go down below to the comments and let me know what dog you have, or if you don't have a dog and you're watching this video, to learn a little bit more about that. But if you do have a dog, let us know down below what they are called, what their breed is, how old they are. I just love reading about other people's dogs, so do let me know down below in the comments. But for now, we're just going to quickly get started. Now, before anyone seriously considers getting a dog, they need to make sure they're looking at the pros and also the cons of getting a dog. Obviously, we have done so many videos on why you should have a dog on this channel, but today we're going to be talking about what you may not have thought about and what you definitely need to think about before you own a dog. So the first main point is that you might be allergic. A lot of people can be allergic to dogs. Now, there is sort of a little curveball around this one because you can actually get hypoallergenic dog breeds, which we have done separate videos on this channel before, so definitely do check those out if you are allergic to dogs. But if you are allergic, it is something that you definitely do have to consider because you might be sneezing and all sorts of things when your dog is around. Now the second one is one that you have to think about, and you also have to think about whether this is fair on your dog as well, and that is if you do travel a lot, you need to think about how often you're going to be seeing that dog, or what you're going to be doing when you are away, if you're going to have to put it in kennels or in boarding, or if you're going to have to leave it with family and friends. It is something you need to think about. If you are traveling a lot, maybe a dog isn't the best option for right now, but when you aren't traveling as much, it might be a good idea to get one then. Now, number three is one that I don't really want Milo to hear, and that is that dogs are really, really high maintenance, aren't you? Yeah, dogs are super, super high maintenance. For one, you need to buy them supplies like treats, dog food, toys, cages, beds, all sorts of leads, poo bags. You need to have loads and loads of things for your dog, and it is very, very high maintenance because you've got to get up early, let them out, feed them. It basically becomes like you've got a child living with you, so you need to definitely be prepared for that. Because remember, a dog is completely dependent on their owner. They're not as independent as cats or as humans, so you definitely need to make sure you are ready to basically look after something for however long they live for. Now, number four sits very, very closely to high maintenance dogs, and that is because it can be a very, very costly thing when you do have a dog. Like I said before, you need to buy food, treats, toys, everything for your dog for them to be able to survive happily, including paying for like their vet bills, any sort of training you want to do, obedience training, etc. There's so many different things you need to take into account. And you also need to think about that if you do decide to take your dog away with you on like a short break, a lot of hotels and places like that do ask for an extra charge with your dog, so again, something to consider. And then number five is one that I absolutely hate talking about, but it's the one reason that whenever I speak to people that don't have a dog and I always ask, why don't you have a dog? They always say this reason, and it is obviously because a dog does have a shorter lifespan. And obviously when a dog does come into your family, they become like an extra member. So it is sad to say, but it is the main reason that people don't decide to get a dog, because they don't want to think about the end result, basically. But that is it for this week's video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Don't forget to let me know what dog you have down below in the comments, or if you don't have a dog, why do you not have a dog? Also, don't forget to follow us over on Instagram. We post loads and loads of different memes. We post competitions as well for you to win your very own t-shirt as well, so definitely do make sure you are following us over there. We are just at RelaxMyDog. Super, super easy to find. Now, before we say bye until next week's video, don't forget to subscribe by clicking this button just over here, and also don't forget to check out last week's video, which is all the way over there as well. Definitely don't forget to click those so you don't miss out on any of our videos. But yes, thank you so much for watching, guys, and me and Milo here, who is extremely tired, we'll see you all next week for next week's video. Bye.